geostationary satellites appears stationary from the Earth. Its orbital plane must be same as the equatorial plane, so that its orbital period is same as the Earth, which is approximately 24 hours. The direction of orbit of geostationary satellite is same as the rotation of Earth, which is towards east. Lastly, the average lifespan of a geostationary satellite is 8 years. Here are some examples of geostationary satellites. Geostationary Operational Environmental Satellite, Meteosat, and Malaysia East Asia Satellite, MESAT. As for non-geostationary satellites, they are situated at any point above the Earth. The orbital period of the non-geostationary satellites is less than or more than 24 hours. The direction of orbit need not to be same as the rotation of Earth. Lastly, the average lifespan of non-geostationary satellite is 5 years. Some examples of non-geostationary satellites are Earth Imaging Satellite, which is the World View Satellite, Global Positioning System, GPS, and the Weather Forecast Satellite. There are a few advantages and disadvantages for both geostationary and non-geostationary satellites. For geostationary satellites, it is always in the same position, so it doesn't need reorientation. As for the disadvantages, the long path of the geostationary satellites causes delay, and can only be governed above the equations, and can't cover polar regions. Advantages of the non-geostationary satellites is it can provide true global coverage. However, more non-geo satellites are required for its proper usage. That is all from me, thank you. If you have any question, can ask my fellow presenter.